Hey friends, I'm back. I totally figured out how to fix our solution of organizing our files without taking them out of the original source and then mixing up all the file names. So the answer to this problem is Adobe Bridge. Adobe Bridge exists for free on the internet. You have to just go to Adobe Bridge in the Adobe Creative Cloud, sign up if you don't already subscribe to any of Adobe's wonderful programs, and then you can download Adobe Bridge for free to start using this to manage your file organizing. I wanted to pop on to tell you why I think photo organizing is so important. This is the number one way to make making your albums easier when you go online to Shutterfly, to Artifact Uprising, to MPix, to any number of solutions that you choose for making your photo albums. If you are organized and you create a simple system for finding your favorite images, you will be able to do this faster. I can't fix the clunkiness of their systems, but I can fix how you organize your files. So I wanted to have you guys see what I do and why I think it's so easy. So I'm just going to show you. Here we are inside Adobe Bridge right now. I have created it so that there's just a few screens that are open so that I can find what I need. On the left side here, I have the folders file where it's just basically your desktop, so you can find where your hard drives are and everything. And then down here, I have collections and metadata so that I can be able to look at an image and see what date it was created and any other identifying information of the file if I really needed it. But I really don't care half the time about that. I just really want to know the date and be able to check from there if anything is somehow out of order chronologically. So going in here, I keep all of my images on an external hard drive. I think I've talked to you about that before, but I wanted to show you how I actually go in and find them. Within my external hard drive, which is, I have two of them plugged in right now because I have so many photos, is different folders I've set up for my business, for Frame of Life, and then for personal. Within my personal files, I've set them up by year. This drive started in October is when I got the new drive. So it just has individual folders from October to December. And then I created a best of folder. I want you to pay special notice to the way I name my file folders just so that I can easily organize them throughout the year with new events that happen and keep my files and images readily available so that I can just pull them up when I need to find them. So my sister's wedding, for example, is here. It's by the date, then her wedding. I have like descriptions of what I'm doing in these pictures. This time period, we moved. Everything was crazy, but I just basically said, this is our party at our old house. It's our new move. And then who are the other people who were in these pictures? Just so that I can quickly keyword search in my finder and pull up all these images fast. I also just know where they are when I look in my drive. What I did here is I created a best of folder as a bucket that I would be moving images that I pull from each of these folders into. And the way I did that is I would open up each folder that I have with all my files. So like this is just my favorites from my trip to Keene this fall. So down here, it's really small right now, but you can pull up all of the photos that I took. These are all my favorite edited photos, but I have them all in this gallery. What I've gone through before recording here today is I went through and I selected my favorites. The way I select favorites is I star them. You can add stars down here by sliding your scroller, mouse over it, or you can do command 5 or whatever number you want, 1 through 5, to get the amount of stars. So I could do 4. Or I have set up a keyword shortcut so that I just have to hit 4 to be able to do it. Right now, these files are being filtered by the stars so that later on I can filter by which ones I've selected. So here's all my 5-star images. Like, I mean, come on. 5-star for me means I'm putting it in my album because, you know, I need to know about this. I choose images to try to set a setting of the time, the place, the people, the events, and like favorite photos from what's happening. So that's just kind of a little background of what I'm using to identify my favorite photos for albums. So what I can do here in Bridge is click one, and then click Command All and select all of them, and then drag them over to the folder. This was in October. I could slide them into the October collection I've created. They are already here because I've already done this. The way to add collections is to click on this button down here, and then it says New Collection. You can rename it. I'm just going to do Test, just so we can have stuff here for now. What Collections does is create a virtual copy of your images instead of actually making full copies. And so anything you do within this does not affect your bank of images here. One thing to make sure you do is say, for example, let me just pull in, like we were just in here. Let me just pull in these three images here to our test folder. If I'm in my test folder and I decide that I don't want this picture in it, if I hit the delete button, it's going to pop up a warning that says, do you want to reject this file or delete it? If I reject or delete, reject will keep it within my gallery, but it will within my normal file structure, but it won't delete it. If I hit delete, it will delete it permanently from both the collection here and the file up here. So what I actually want to do is double click on this and say remove from collection, because that's what I really want to do. I don't want to remove it from my hard drive. I just want to take it out of this collection. So now there's only two images. So if you accidentally hit the delete button, just read this warning and hit cancel, and then hit double click and go to remove collection. Okay. Does that make any sense? Hope it does. But the benefit of all of this is within here, I now have, as I went through for, in 1 hour, guys, I timed this today. I went through and I created folders for each month, for the year of 2018, and put my favorite images. I like went through all of them, picked my favorites with the 5 stars, moved them in over here, set up these collections so that then I could create a best of folder for 2018. And within that, I took each collection, and I, replicated the file. So I actually had to go in here and hit new folder, and I'm going to just do test because we don't have test yet. And I'll show you, it pops up down here, but I basically did, the best of, and then I did new folder, added each one of these, and then within each one of those, I went and I pulled our images from it to add to it. So I will pull this test one up to here to show you. And what that now does is create a real copy of the image. So this image should be now in there, and it is. So when I get out of Adobe Bridge, I can go into my Finder, pull up my hard drive, and locate this file, the best of test. And there it is, okay? So this now just created a real copy by moving it from the collection into the actual folders on my hard drive. One also amazing thing, let me show you this trick. This is how you can rename your folder, your images quickly. Let me go back here real fast and grab just a few more images to add to the test so that I can show you how renaming can happen really awesomely and easily. So see how these have different file names down here and they're not really super descriptive. This whole KRSI photography thing is like, it's just too much. I don't want that on there. So what I can do is select all of these images and let's pretend that they're all my house. Like, so this is like a one series of images. I'm going to go in here and you can batch rename them. So what you can do is come up here. I want to try to get a file structure where the date is what's showing first. And I've chosen to go by the month, the day, the year. And then I'm going to just get rid of the KRSI photography part. So you can like pick different sequences and different names that you want it to have. Right now, this is the current file name, so it's going to have that. But you can also just make it a text. So I could just change all of these images to be before pics at 74, which is our new house. So it would be by date and then before pics. I can even just, so then I know like where it is. And then to do that, you can have it say that it's going to rename it in the same folder. It renames these actual images and saves that image as that now. So what you can see now is all those images have been renamed, and then you go into test to see it, and they're there. Like, I don't believe they're down here because we didn't put them into my collection, but they're up here where I was changing the file names in my folder structure, and you'll see that here in the actual folder structure. Right, best of test. See, they're changed. So now I would go in here on Bridge, and I would change this one to be by the date as well. But I would say instead, hang on one second, badger name. I would say this one is in Keene. And I'll say Willa Keene, where that was. Just so I know what it is, where it is, and that's the date. Rename. One other thing to keep in mind with this is when you're going back to find these actual images, forget that part. This will work pretty great. So they're all there. Now, what you're going to do is later you're going to be going into your Shutterfly and you're going to load 2018 Best Of, and you're going to take in one folder at a time and create the pages for your album using just one folder at a time. If you're doing a wedding, you can set this up with like, here is wedding. And then you could have getting ready, you could have detail shots, you could have the reception, you could have favorite people, and you could coordinate it that way based on how you're going to tell the story in your album. So basically set up chapters of what you're going to have in your album and put the pictures in there that way using this collections down here, and then you can organize it to dump them into your folders. I can go through specifically and show you how to organize a wedding album next. So that's coming. So comment below if you really want to see that. All right. Thanks so much, guys. I hope this helped answer some questions.